This is Frank Dominguez, and I'm in the green room of the Belk Theater at the Blumenthal Performing Arts Center. And my guest is the pianist Yulianna Avdeeva, who is here to perform with the Charlotte Symphony Orchestra. Three concerts as part of this classic series weekend on Thursday, Friday, and Saturday evening. And it's my pleasure to welcome her and to talk a little bit about the program that she's got planned. Yulianna, welcome, and thank you for speaking with me.
Hello. Thank you very much for bringing me here.
Well, I'd like you to talk a little bit about Chopin, first of all, because you've had so much success performing Chopin's music, and you'll be playing his Piano Concerto No. 2 with the symphony this weekend. So tell me about Chopin, and what is it about his music that speaks to you and has made you a successful interpreter of his music?
For me, I have to say what makes Chopin's music actually so unique and so singular is that his music combines a certain clarity in a very classical structure, a formal structure. So his every piece he composed, starting from small mazurkas or preludes, finishing with bigger works like ballads or scherzi, they have a very clear, as I said, almost classical structure, which is based on the form of which Mozart or Haydn were using. But on the same time, his music has this certain improvising moment, which is so unpredictable and also changes from time to time. And this combination makes his music so, I can say, difficult to perform. Another point is that I think that it is very important to be able to, because now we have the resources, we have the original Chopin manuscripts. There is a new last edition of all Chopin works, which have been done by Jan Ekia, Polish pianist and Polish musicologist, who actually was working for 30 years on this final edition. The unique thing about this edition is that Ekia was really going everywhere where he could find the original Chopin manuscripts of all his pieces. So that means that it's original Chopin piece of paper which we see. So I think it is very important to know the composer's will, to really understand every remark which he has left in his music, because he was quite precise in what he actually wanted. And on the other hand, it is always this personal touch, this personal language which you find in his music and which you have to find in his music. And these are all aspects which I think make every performance of Chopin's music so individual, so unique.
Now, you're performing Piano Concerto No. 2 by Chopin, but it's actually not his second piano concerto. Is that correct?
Yes, that's right.
How did that happen? When was this one written?
Well, they were both the E minor and F minor concerto. They were both written in the same period. So it was 1830, and just somehow, it just happened that the E minor concerto has been printed, so it became number one, and the F minor became number two.
So it had to do with the publication order and not when it was
written.
Yes,
exactly. It has nothing to do with the timing of composing the works. They are, of course, as they are written in the same period of time, Chopin was 19, 20 years old. So both concertos have some similar sides, but on the other hand, for me, especially when you perform them together, they are completely different. They are different in a pianistic style. They are different in an expression. F minor concerto is for me more intimate. So it's well known that by that time Chopin was very much in love with a Polish young singer, Konstancja Gładkowska, but that was a kind of platonic love. So he never felt strong enough to talk to her or something. So it was really just a kind of I don't know, very, very special feeling which he had towards her. And I think the second movement of the concerto, which is for me indeed a real area, so it's a really singing, it's a melody which is accompanied by the left hand in the piano and also, of course, supported by the orchestra. So it's a kind of dedication to her. The third movement has a color of Polish dances.
Mm-hmm.
So it's a completely different character. There is a mazurka part in it. There is a waltz part in it. So it's really very, for me, it's very youthful, very enthusiastic piece.
Mm-hmm. Do you remember when you first encountered Chopin's music?
Yes, well, I remember what I can remember. I was maybe 6 or 7 years old, and I got the recording of Josef Hoffmann playing the E flat major nocturne. And somehow there is a kind of special mystery around Chopin's music always, because nocturne is a night song, let's say. Yes, indeed. And the E flat major nocturne, Opus 9, is actually very simple written, but the way Hoffmann also performed it, the way he played the piece, that was so spectacular that I was very moved. But as I said, this mystery around Chopin's music, this feeling, it's very special music for me. The real feeling of understanding his music came actually during my preparation for the Chopin competition, where I was indeed in a certain way diving into his world. I was reading a lot about the circumstances which surrounded him during not only his biographies, but also some works of writers he was a friend with, like, of course, George Sand, but also some other artists, or watching the paintings of Eugène Delacroix,
mm-hmm.
which was also a very good friend of him, and of course listening to some music of composers he was friend with. And I think that all gives you a kind of, it's like a puzzle. And for me, I had a feeling that I'm coming closer in my imagination. I'm coming closer to his world. I start really feeling what maybe he could feel when he was composing his music. And that is very, I think it's a very special, really very special feeling for me.
I'm glad you brought up the competition, because I wanted to ask you about it. You not only participated in it, but you were the first prize winner in 2010. Is there a particular memory of that experience that stays with you as being a high point of the experience, other than winning?
Well, I have to say, in general, these 3 weeks I have spent in Warsaw during the competition, they will always stay in my mind as something very unique, I have to say, because Warsaw is I have to say that in general, the Poles, they are so enthusiastic about Chopin music. So, and that was 2010, it was 200th anniversary of his birthday, so it was a very, very special year. It was celebrated everywhere, and Warsaw still has so many places where Chopin has been to. There is his apartment where he was living for, I think, last year before he left Warsaw. There is a church he was playing in. There is, of course, the church where his heart rests, and there is a fantastic Chopin Museum, which is very new, which was opened in 2010, which features so many manuscripts, his pianos also. So it's a very inspiring time which I have spent there. And of course, this feeling, because when you're walking in the middle of the city, you heard Chopin's pieces played everywhere. So it was a very special atmosphere also in the city, and this enthusiastic feeling which surrounded me there, that was something what I will never forget.
Well, winning that competition has really launched your career into another level, shall we say. And I'm wondering, now that you're touring internationally and performing regularly, what's the best thing about being a touring concert pianist?
Well, there are many interesting or exciting points about being a concert pianist. I have a chance to work with fantastic orchestras in very different parts of the world, to perform with different conductors, to visit new places, to perform for new audiences in different places, and this is what I admire so much. Even if I don't speak the language of the country I'm performing the music, is this universal language which connects me with the people all over the world, that we understand each other, mm-hmm. we communicate through the music, and this is this feeling to share this treasure, this treasure as a musician with the other people. That's a fantastic thing.
One final question. Apart from Chopin, you must play other composers and other music. So what are some of the things that you're looking forward to playing, either in concerts or perhaps recordings, that you haven't necessarily played yet?
Well, I have to say I'm quite a curious person. So, of course, Chopin's music has a very special, plays a special role in my repertoire and in my life, I can even say. But there are also so many different styles and periods which I think are, for me, very interesting and very important also to learn. In June I will be playing, I play really very various repertoires. So in June, for instance, I will be having a special project with Gidon Kremer and the Kremerata Baltica at the Musikverein in Vienna. We're doing Weinberg Shostakovich project, so it will be four evenings, or four concerts in 2 days, not evenings, but four concerts in 2 days, where we will be performing different pieces by Weinberg. I will be playing the piano quintet in arrangement for the chamber orchestra and piano, and the Shostakovich first piano concerto with Kremerata Baltica. Last year I have recorded a CD with Schubert three piano pieces, seventh Prokofiev sonata and 24 preludes by Chopin. So it's a very, actually, let's say it's not a very usual program, but I would say that I would not like at the moment to limit myself and play that and say that I would like to concentrate myself on this repertoire. I think I can decide that a bit later, and at the moment I'm just happy to learn as much as possible also about other styles and other periods.
Wonderful. Well, Yulianna Avdeeva, thank you so much for your time and the best of luck. Enjoy your visit to Charlotte, and we look forward to hearing you in concert with the Charlotte Symphony Orchestra.
Thanks a lot.